Welcome to BMC Helix Business Workflows. I'm Anushree, Associate Information Developer at BMC Software. In this video, I'm going to give a quick overview of Flowsets and how to configure them. A Flowset is a way in which customers can define their business flows for different lines of business. Customers can define Flowsets to implement their custom business logic along with the out-of-the-box logic, or to override the out-of-the-box logic. This figure shows the different out-of-the-box workflows like initialization, assignment, validation, status transition, and data access model. By default, these workflows are involved when you create a case. By using Flowsets, you can either extend these workflows or override them to execute your custom business logics. For the purpose of this video, let us take a use case that when a case priority is critical and the category tier 1 field is blank, the case agent needs to specify the category tier 1 field. Without specifying the field, the case agent cannot save the case. This use case involves certain steps. First, create a process that displays an error to a case agent if the tier 1 field is blank. Then, register the process with the process library and associate it with a flow set. After that, create a case template with the defined flow set and use that template to create a case. To create a process, as a case business analyst, log in to BMC Helix Innovation Studio. You can view all the applications and libraries to which you have access. Go to the Case Management Library and click Processes. The recommended way to design a process is to create a copy of an out-of-the-box process. Select the sample process for case validations and click Copy. In the copy of the process, the input parameters and permissions are displayed automatically. This process has three input parameters: a case instance variable, a previous case record, and an operation. The operation parameter determines when the process should be run, that is, when I create a case or update a case. Let us enter the process details. Enter the process name. From the palette, add the conditional and show alert elements. When the defined condition is not met, the showAlert element displays an error. Now, build the condition as priority is equal to critical and category tier 1 is equal to null. Then, for the showAlert element, build an expression with the error message that you want to show to the case agent. Also, set the alert type as error, because you do not want the case agent to proceed with a case without specifying the category tier 1 field. To define an unconditional block, join the conditional and the end elements. After creating the process, you need to register it. Go to BMC Helix Business Workflows and, in Settings, go to Process Library. Click Register Process and enter the details. Select Case Management Library as you created the process in it. Select the process name and add a description for the process. Set the status to active so that you can use the process in the Flowset mapping. To map the process with a Flowset, open the Human Resources Sample Flowset. Go to Manage Process and click Add New Mapping. The functions list shows the different workflows that we saw earlier in this video to extend or override the out-of-the-box logics. Specify the function as validations and select the process name. Select the execution type as additive so that the process is run along with other process. Then, set the status to active. The next step is to create a case template. To do this, In Settings, navigate to Case Management, Case Template. Click the Case Template option and enter the details like template name, company, and so on. Specify the flow set as human resources and other details according to your requirements. Now, create a case with the defined case template. The category Day 1 field is blank. The case priority is high and the case is saved successfully. Create a case with priority as critical by using the same case template and without a value for category Day 1. While saving the case, an error is displayed that was drafted as a part of the process. Because the condition defined in the process is met, the error is displayed, and this shows that the defined process is successfully executed. I hope this video helped you to understand why and how to use flowsets for your applications. Thank you for watching.